H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Hi everyone. Today we are going to have a Selenium demo, kind of introduction. What is meant by Selenium? What are the different components in Selenium? What are the advantages, disadvantages, and we'll try to compare Selenium with QGP tool. This is a direct concept in Selenium components. So before we discuss Selenium components, let's have a brief introduction to automation testing. Like, we'll briefly try to understand what is meant by automation and what are the different automation tools available and what is this Selenium. Okay. Before we start here, we'll start from automation testing. First of all, what is meant by testing? The perfect definition for testing is conformance to the requirements, validating whether application is meeting the requirements or not. Okay, the main definition or the actual definition for the testing is conformance to the requirements, validating whether application is meeting the requirements or not. And what is meant by automation? Here I'm just asking just automation. I'm not talking about automation testing. I'm just asking the definition of automation. Okay. Just the definition of automation is automating the manual process. When whatever we do as part of manual process, we will try to automate it. Automating the manual process is called as automation. For example, say a washing machine automates the process of washing clumps. Right. Washing machine as a automation, it automates the process of washing the clumps. Okay, here I can call this washing machine as a tool. So this washing machine, we can call this is a tool. Now we'll try to find what is meant by automation testing. It was just talking about testing, and then we'll just try to find out what is meant by automation. Okay. Now we'll try to find out what is meant by automation testing. Automation testing means automating the manual testing process. It is called as automation testing. So here In this example, we understood a general terminology, what is meant by automation. And here we understand that there are some tools which automates the manual process. One of the examples is washing machine is a tool. In a similar way, for automating the testing process, here also we have some tools. We have tools. One of the tool is Selenium. There are n number of tools available. There is a QTP, Selenium, Test Partner, Rational Functional Tester, Silk Test. So many other tools available. One of the famous tool is Selenium. Now we'll discuss about Selenium. So before we jumping into Selenium, actually I was giving a brief introduction to what is meant by automation testing. This is a kind of the highlighted part as a brief introduction to automation testing. Now here we actually jumping into Selenium. Selenium is a browser-based automation tool. Selenium basically it is an automation tool for automating the web browsers. It's a browser-based automation tool. Now we'll go back to our PPT here. So this is a general definition of Selenium, and Selenium is not a single tool. It consists of three different tools. Generally we call it as a suite of tools. In other words, we can call Selenium components. When we talk about Selenium here, Selenium is a web browser based automation tool. Selenium is not a single tool, it consists of three different tools, or we can say it is a suite of tools or Selenium components. Now here we actually started with Selenium components here. Selenium is a suite of tools, and here we can also call it as a Selenium components. Selenium IDE is one of the component. Selenium RC or Webdriver. If you observe here, RC and Webdriver, they are separated with a pipe. I will come back to those. And Selenium Grid. These are the three main components of Selenium. Here it is starting with Selenium IDE. Here IDE means, the term IDE means Integrated Development Environment. And basically Selenium IDE is a Firefox plugin. When we talk about the Selenium IDE component, this is a Firefox plugin. It means it is one of the add-in to the Firefox browser. I will show this particular Selenium IDE tool here, and once we discuss about this, I will show this. And the main features of Selenium IDE is, here we can record and we can play back the script. It's a kind of a handycam. In a handycam, we can shoot a video and we can replay that video, right? In a similar way, this Selenium IDE, by using Selenium IDE, we can record and then we can play back. It means in any application, we can record a test case or we can record a scenario and we can replay it back. And generally, any automation tool will have a basic feature like record and playback. Selenium is also having this record and playback feature in the Selenium IDE component. And here there is a provision to export to required language. Here in the Selenium IDE, there is an option to export the recorded script into different languages. Here in Selenium IDE, we can export into Java, we can export into C#, we can export into Python, Perl, PHP, Ruby. There is a provision to export into different languages here. It means in Selenium IDE, we can record a script in HTML format. Basically, Selenium IDE records the script in HTML format. From that HTML format, they can export into any required language. Say I have joined a company. That company is working using Ruby. Okay, there is a scripting language called Ruby. Okay, if that company is working Selenium with Ruby, in that case, we can export the scripts into Ruby. Okay, in general, most of the organizations uses Selenium with Java. So in general, here we can export into Java. Okay, and the main use of this Selenium IDE is for exploratory testing. It means generally this Selenium IDE will not be used in real time. We will not use Selenium IDE to build our scripts. Basically, we use Selenium Webdriver. Selenium IDE will not be used in real time. Okay. It's mainly for exploratory testing. It means it's a kind of a smoke test. Say whenever there is a new build comes in, if you want to make sure that our application is properly working, just to check it thoroughly, probably a manual tester can open Selenium IDE and can record a basic navigations in the Selenium IDE. And whenever there is a new build comes in, or when for each day starting, just to make sure that application is working properly in a very high level, they can use the Selenium IDE scripts. Okay. But however, as part of course, we are going to discuss this Selenium IDE in depth. And here, this is the starting point to learn the Selenium. Okay. If you have any questions, we'll come back to that. As I said, please make note of your questions in Notepad. We'll go further. Now, Selenium RC. Selenium, if you remember here, as part of Selenium components, Selenium here, I said Selenium RC or Selenium Webdriver this. Okay. Now we are jumping into Selenium RC. Here RC means remote control. Here RC means remote control, and we can also call it as Selenium 1.0. This was the first version of Selenium. Whenever the Selenium was introduced to the market, it was introduced as Selenium RC. We can also call it as Selenium 1.0. And here in Selenium the Selenium RC, we can write the scripts in Java, Python, Ruby, .NET. Now it is deprecated. When I say here deprecated means this Selenium RC has been outdated. Nowadays the organization which is providing Selenium, that organization itself is not encouraging us to use this Selenium RC. Okay, because it is older version, it has some set of challenges. Okay, all those set of challenges has been overcome in the new version of Selenium. That is the reason the organization which is providing Selenium, they are not encouraging us to use Selenium RC. Okay, the underlying concept of Selenium RC is it uses some Selenium server to run the scripts. We'll discuss these things technically in coming classes. Okay, in regular classes we'll understand the technical difference between Selenium RC and Selenium Webdriver. Okay, I'm just skipping this particular point. Now Selenium Webdriver. It can be also called as Selenium 2.0. It is the latest version. Okay, and now the organization which is providing Selenium, they are encouraging us to use Selenium Webdriver. Okay, and here it don't need any Selenium server to run the scripts. Basically, Selenium RC uses some concept to execute the scripts. Now here in Selenium Webdriver, that concept has been removed. In other words, in simple words, I can say, in Selenium RC, there was another dependency. Whenever we want to run the scripts, we had to make sure that one server is on. But here in Selenium Webdriver, we don't need to bother about that. It can be handled with the script itself. Okay. We'll discuss, however, we'll discuss these things in the coming classes. Again, this is the technical difference between Selenium RC and Selenium Webdriver. I'm just skipping this. The next component is Selenium Grid. Selenium Grid, basically it is a concept. It is just a concept. It's not kind of a user interface. It does not have any user interface. Selenium Grid is a concept to execute multiple scripts on multiple machines. There, if you read this, scale by distributing tests on several machines, parallel execution. It means, say you have 20 scripts. say you have 20 automation scripts and say you have 5 machines, you can distribute these 20 automation scripts on these 5 machines. Okay, that can be achievable by using the Selenium grid concept. Yes, you are here in our class, we are going to discuss even Selenium grid. We will try to execute scripts on multiple machines. Here, when we say multiple machines, means one machine can be a Linux, one machine can be a Windows 7, one machine can be a Windows XP, Windows 8, Windows 7, like that. So we can cover or we can test different things, and we can make sure that our application is properly working on all those different areas. Okay. And however, if you see here, manage multiple environments from a central point, making it easy to run the test against a vast combination of browsers and operating systems. So that is what I'm explaining here. Let's say we can have a Linux, we can execute on Linux, we can execute on Windows XP, we can execute on Windows 7, Windows 8, and even the different browsers configuration. That can be possible using Selenium grid. Okay. The only thing is, we need to have infrastructure, we need to have multiple machines with multiple operating system and multiple browser combination, and then from the Selenium grid we can execute a single script on multiple combinations. This is like a very high level of Selenium components. Okay. Let me give more details here. I'm saying Selenium components, right? So as we discussed here, we have a Selenium IDE, Selenium RC, or Webdriver, and then Selenium grid. Let me give a brief info again. Selenium IDE, here as I said, plugin in Firefox. Okay, here I can say the main uses or functions of Selenium IDE are, we can record a script, we can replay a script, and we can export the script into different languages. When I say here different languages, it can be Java, it can be C#, Ruby, Perl, Python, like this. Okay, I will come back to this. And I said Selenium RC. Selenium RC means, RC means remote control. It's a older version. Now it is called as Selenium 1.0. It has been deprecated, outdated, and then we discussed Selenium Webdriver. This is the latest version. You can also call it a Selenium 2.0. Okay. And if anyone of your friend asks in Selenium what you are going to understand, yep, you can say you are going to discuss Selenium Webdriver. Okay. Because Selenium RC is outdated, it is not preferable to invest time on that. So we are basically going to discuss Selenium Webdriver in our classes. And then Selenium grid. Like multiple scripts on multiple machines. The machines are like multiple operating system and browser configurations. Okay. Now I'll try to find out the advantages of Selenium. First thing, if we talk about cost, it's free, or technically we call it as a open source. Open source means you can download and you can use. The cost of Selenium is nothing. I mean, you don't need to spend a single cent for the tool. It's just free. You can just download and you can use it. You don't need to spend a single cent for the tool. And it supports multiple browsers. Okay. It supports multiple browsers. Basically, it supports Firefox. It supports Internet Explorer. It supports Chrome. It supports Opera. Safari, okay, Netscape, and moreover here, here it supports, when I say Firefox, it supports almost all versions, okay. When I say almost all versions, in the sense, in Firefox, it is going to support almost all versions of Firefox. And here Selenium supports almost all versions of all the browsers. Okay. It supports multiple browsers. It is going to support these varieties of browsers. And moreover, it is going to support almost all versions of all the browsers. Okay. It supports multiple operating systems. It supports Windows, Linux, Unix, iOS, even our mobile devices. Android. Library. Okay. It supports even multiple operating systems too. And then here we have a choice of language. Choice of language means here in Selenium we can use Java, we can use C sharp. Say I want to build automation scripts using C sharp. Yes, you can use C sharp like this. You can use Java, C sharp, Python, Perl, Ruby, PHP. Okay, say if you are expert in Ruby. Yes, you can use Ruby to build the scripts. Say if you are expert in Perl, you can use Perl to build the automation scripts, Selenium automation scripts. Okay. However, in our class, we are going to limit it to Java. We are going to understand the Selenium Webdriver with Java. I will explain why we have chosen Java. I will give you a reason for that. Okay. So these are the main four advantages of Selenium, like cost, multiple browsers, multiple operating system, and choice of language. And most of the people assumes that Selenium is getting more popular because the cost, because it is a free tool, Selenium is getting more demand. Most of the people assumes that this is the reason, but that is not the actual reason. Selenium is getting more demand because of this reason. Okay. Because of this particular reason, Selenium is getting more demand in the market. Okay. Because it supports multiple browsers, it supports multiple operating system. So because of this reason, Selenium is getting more demand in the market. Okay. The secondary reason is this cost. The primary reason is this. Okay. Now, we have been understanding the advantages of Selenium, right? We'll try to list down the disadvantages of Selenium. Here, basically Selenium supports, as I said earlier, supports only web, we can automate only web application, right? Supports only web applications. It means we can automate Windows, SAP, Oracle, mainframe. The other types of application cannot be automated using Selenium. By using Selenium, it can automate only Windows-based applications. Web applications. It means the applications which can be opened through the browsers, like the application which can be opened through the Firefox, Google Chrome, Internet Explorer. The applications which can be opened through the browsers, or the application which can be accessed across the internet, can be supported by Selenium. Okay. The second point is, there is no official support. It means if you got stuck somewhere, okay, there is no particular person to help you. Okay, however, we will come back to this this particular point. I mean, say you find some difficulty with the tool. Okay, yes, you can raise your concern, but basically you cannot demand that this tool is not working properly. Okay, because it is an open source, you just downloaded and you are using it. Okay, basically you cannot demand anyone. That's where I'm saying no, there is no official support. We'll come back to that. These are the advantages and disadvantages of Selenium. Now, we will try to compare Selenium with the QTP tool. Why I'm going to compare with QTP? Because QTP is one more another famous tool in the automation testing. Okay. We'll try to see the differences between Selenium and QTP. As I said, QTP is one more famous tool. Okay, it is one of the famous tool in automation testing. That is the reason we are trying to compare this Selenium with QTP here. Okay, here the first point I said, cost of the Selenium tool is free, whereas the EFT tool is, or QTP or EFT tool, that is a very highly paid tool. Among the paid tools itself, it is a very highly paid tool. Okay, for QTP we have to pay a lot of money. Okay, it is a very highly paid tool among the paid tools. And here we are talking about multiple browsers, right? Yes, QTP supports Firefox, it supports Internet Explorer, it supports Chrome, and it is not going to support Opera, it is not going to support Safari, it is not going to support Netscape. And here, yes, QTP supports Firefox, but it is not going to support all the versions. It supports only limited versions of Firefox. Okay. Yes, Internet Explorer, yes, it supports almost all versions. And Chrome, again, limited versions. The Chrome browser, QTP supports Chrome browser, but again, limited versions only. Okay. And moreover, it is HP. The organization HP provides QTP. It claims that it supports Firefox and Chrome, but to make it support, we have to do so many other extra installations, and moreover, we have to take. There might be some special considerations that we have to handle at the based on the browser type also. Okay, and here coming to the multiple operating system, QTP supports only on Windows. It cannot be installed on any other operating system. Okay, only Windows. QTP can work with only Windows. It cannot support Linux, Unix, iOS, Android, BlackBerry. It is not going to be supported. It supports only Windows. And here we don't have any choice of language. Here, whether you know or whether you don't know, you have to use VBScript. Okay. Then QTP, whether you know about the tool or whether you know VBScript, whether you don't know VBScript, you have to use VBScript here. Whereas in Selenium, we have a choice here. Okay? And here QTP can be installed only on Windows. It means we can work with only Windows, and it supports Firefox with the limited versions. It supports Internet Explorer all the versions. It supports Chrome again limited versions, and it is a very highly paid tool. Now, if you try to compare the with the disadvantages of Selenium here, basically, QTP supports it supports almost all types of applications. Okay, it means it supports web applications, it supports Windows applications, okay, it supports SAP, Oracle, mainframe. You just name a technology, that technology will almost it is going to be supported by TTP. Okay, however, we'll come back to this point. We'll try to analyze this about this point. And here, yes, there is a support, there is an official support. In a sense, if you got stuck somewhere, you can raise your concern with the HP, because we are paying very high money, right? So obviously, if you got stuck somewhere, you can basically demand the HP to look into the issue. Okay. However, we'll come back to these two points again. Now, these are the this is the comparison between Selenium and QTP. However, we'll try to analyze each and every point over here. I said cost is free for the Selenium. Okay. So, to whom it is going to be concerned? It is going to be concerned for an organization. So here, in terms of organization, point of view, okay, give me a minute. Let me say it's analysis. We are trying to analyze each point here. Okay, the cost of the tool is free, and here it is a very highly paid tool. So in terms of organization point of view, say if they go for, if the organization is go for Selenium, what they actually are they going to invest any money? Organization is not, it is not going to invest any single cent for the tool. Okay, what they need, just a person who has Selenium knowledge. Okay, what organization actually needs here, they need resources who has Selenium knowledge, and they don't need to spend a single cent for anything. Okay, only the thing is they just need a resource who has knowledge in Selenium. That's it. They don't need to spend a single cent for any other things. So that is where the demand for Selenium is getting increased in most of the organizations. Okay, because instead of hiring a normal QA person, instead of hiring a normal manual tester, they are trying to hire a person who has Selenium knowledge, because in future, or if they want to plan, if they are planning for any automation, just they can make use of the Selenium, because they just need to download and they can use it. So if they have a resource who has Selenium knowledge, for them that's it. They don't need to invest on any other things. Okay, so this is a very good point for an automation point of view. Okay, now coming to this point, say I said we discussed Selenium supports multiple browsers, multiple operating systems. Yes, of course, it supports. Then who bothers, who cares about it? Here, say for example, we are testing, this application, H2Kinfosys.com. Okay, I can test this particular application probably in Internet Explorer using QTP, and if it works properly, I can conclude that my application is working properly, right? Then what is the need? Whether it supports or does not support, who cares? I'm saying, say we have htkinfosys.com, okay? And here, by using this Internet Explorer, by using this QTP, we can test it, and we can conclude whether it is working properly or not. Then, but if the tool is going to support all these browsers and all these versions, and if it supports all this operating system, who cares? I can able to test my application using Internet Explorer, right? Yes. It was a perception around 6 to 7 years ago. Okay, whenever we wanted to test a web application, we simply used to test in Internet Explorer. Okay, but now the testing strategy has been changing. Okay, now the end user arena has been changing. As an end user, now we are able to access this application even in our mobile devices, right? We are accessing in our iPhone, in our Samsung devices, in our Android devices, I mean to say here. Okay, we have to make sure that our application is properly working in in any operating system, in any browser. I mean, it can be any browser. In around 6 to 7 years ago, most of the people uses Internet Explorer. So at that time, we used to test the application in Internet Explorer only. Okay, because at that time, most of the out of 100 users, around 70 to 75 people users habituated to use Internet Explorer only. But nowadays, what's happening? Most of the users using Firefox, Chrome, different browsers, as well as different versions of the browser. When we say Firefox, okay, say in my machine, I'm using the latest version, 28th version. Say the other user may using a older version, say 24th version. So we have to make sure that our application is properly working in 24th version of Firefox, and in 25th version of Firefox, in 28th version of Firefox. And it should work properly again in Windows operating system, Linux operating system, Unix operating system. We have to make sure that application is properly available in all the operating systems, all the browsers, and all the versions of the browser. So basically, if you can test this kind of things, it gives more confidence on our application. Okay, yes, earlier days we used to test on Internet Explorer, but now as the end users are changing, we have end users means we ourselves are the end users. Nowadays we are accessing the applications using the mobile devices. Now the trend has been changed. Now we have to make sure that our application is properly working in all this operating system, browser, and then browser version configurations. Because an end user may use a Linux operating system, an end user may use a Windows operating system, Unix operating system, or may use any browser or any version of the browser. Okay. Now basically by using Selenium, what we can do here, we can build a single script. We can build a single script and we can make this single script to work on around 120 plus combinations. Okay. Basically, if you consider this versions of the browser, if you consider this types of browsers, and if you consider this operating system, you can list down around 120 plus combinations. Okay. So we can develop a single script and we can make it to execute on this 120 plus combinations. And we can see whether our application is properly working in all these combinations. So by doing this, what we are going to achieve? We are going to achieve the confidence on our application. Okay. We will make sure that our application is properly working in all these combinations. So end user may use any combination. We have a confidence that yes, our application is going to work properly. And are we going to spend any money for this? No. It's just simple. Just we are downloading and we are using it. Okay. So basically, because of these features, Selenium is getting more demand in the market. Okay, of course, in terms of organization point of, this is the reason. But however, in general, why Selenium is getting more demand in the market? Because of these features, Selenium is getting more demand in the market. And this is a secondary point. Okay, and here, coming to this point, I said we are going to discuss in our class Java, Selenium Webdriver with Java. Why we are choosing Java? Because most of the developers across the world are the Java developers. Okay, and if you got stuck somewhere or if you need any help in terms of Java, there are so many resources available on Java. And moreover, the most of the Selenium openings will be on Java. Okay, most of the organizations are expecting Selenium Webdriver with Java. That is where we are going to understand Java here. We are going to discuss Java in our class, and don't get scared when you look at this word Java. Okay, to be frank, say if you know each and everything in Java, why would we looking for the Selenium? Why will think about the Selenium? We would become Java developers itself, right? So here we don't need to be expert in Java. Okay, here basically we need to at the same time, I cannot say here we need basics. I can say here we need a knowledge which is more than basics, less than the advanced Java. And moreover, most of the people assume that Java is a complex language. Yes, it is going to be a complex language. I have my own perception, like if it is going to be taught, if it is going to be taught, it depends on the trainer. Basically, it depends on the trainer. And believe me, I will know if there are any person who are new to IT. Okay, even in my old batches, there are some set of people who are new to IT. Even they were able to write, they were able to understand Java, and now they are able to write Selenium scripts using Java. Okay. After 40 to 50% of the course, you will be in a position to write Selenium scripts by on your own. Okay. That is my, I can give that guarantee. And don't scared when you look at this word Java. Java actually is easy, but it depends on the trainer who teaches it. Okay. And here in our class, we are mainly concentrated. We will discuss the Java with respect to a real analogy examples. Okay, that is where basically you can understand this Java easily. Yeah. Coming to this point, disadvantages. I said supports Selenium supports only web application, right? Now, basically, if you look at the statistics, out of 100 applications, so if you consider 100 applications, out of 100 different applications, around 70 to 75 applications are web-based applications. Okay, and the remaining 25 to 30 applications the other types of application like SAP, mainframe, here I was listing down, right? Oracle, these applications. Okay. Now, if you consider the statistics, yes. Now, here most of the applications, around 3/4 applications are on the web. Okay. Now, here there is a lot of opportunity for us to use Selenium here in this area. Okay. In this area, of course, earlier QTP has more demand. Now, the demand for QTP is decreasing. The demand for Selenium is increasing. Okay, if you consider the statistics, around 3/4 applications are web applications. So it's okay. If we have any web application, we can prefer the Selenium. And moreover, the demand for Selenium is increasing nowadays. The demand for QTP is decreasing in the web application arena. Okay, now if you consider these applications, yes, if these kind of applications, of course, we cannot automate using Selenium. But here in this area, in this arena, still QTP is a monopoly. Monopoly in the sense, it is the only tool which supports all these applications properly and with a very high level. Okay. In this area, I can say, in this applications, I can say QTP is still a strong tool. Okay. But in this web application, yes, now the Selenium is getting more demand in the market. Okay. So here it supports web application. Of course, there are most of the applications are web. And here I said no official support. However, even if you don't have any official support, you can raise your concern in the Selenium official website. Okay. But basically, you cannot expect, you cannot demand them to look into the issue. Okay. And moreover, if you got stuck somewhere, there are most online forums available. If you really got stuck somewhere, you can raise your concern, you can post your concern in one of the forum. You can definitely get a reply for that. Okay, because there are most of the people use Selenium. So if you post your question on the online forums, you can definitely, you will get a solution for that. But it's not official. It's a kind of, you just raising your concern in some forums. And it's like you're not you cannot demand them. Okay. This is the overall idea on Selenium advantages, disadvantages, and it is comparison with QTP, and we are trying to understand each point in detail here. Okay. Now, we'll have a brief, we'll take a simple test case. Okay. We'll try to record that particular simple test case in Selenium IDE. Let me say Selenium demo with a sample script. Okay. Here first we'll define it test case or test scenario. Okay. See here let us open eb.com. Okay. The first step is say open www.eb.com. and then enter camera, and then click on search button. Actually, I'm talking about this. Okay. Open this eb.com, and here in this text box, enter camera and click on this search button. And here, once we got the results, say, assume I want to click on this daily deals. Okay, we click on the daily deals. This is a sample test case. We will try to automate this particular sample test case. Okay. Now we'll start from Selenium IDE. Okay. Here I said the uses are the functions of Selenium IDE is here we can record, we can replay, and we can export, right? We'll try to understand these three steps in a very high level. And moreover, if you observe here, I said plugin in Firefox. Selenium IDE is a plugin in Firefox, right? Now this is a Firefox browser. Okay. Now here tools. If you go to tools menu, there is something called Selenium IDE. This Selenium IDE I have installed in my machine. Okay. And there will be exclusive session for the Selenium installation. This is called a Selenium IDE. Okay. And we'll try to record by using the Selenium IDE, we will try to record this, and we will try to record give me a minute. So here we'll try to record the test case that we have defined here. We'll try to record this particular test case. Once we record, we'll try to replay it. Once we replay, we'll try to export. Like here, we're just trying to understand this basic features. Okay, this record, replay. So first we'll go here. And let's come to the homepage in this eb.com here. Now, as of now, here don't concentrate much about the technical part. Okay. However, we are going to discuss these things in detail in the coming classes. So I'm just clicking on record button here. Here, basically, we have to wait this browser to stabilize. Okay. Now, see here, I'm recording. I'm entering camera, and then I'm clicking on this search button. And I'm again just waiting for this browser to stabilize. Now I'm clicking on this daily deals here. Now if you go to this Selenium IDE here, let me stop the recording. If you close the observer, it has been recorded some four steps. Okay. Whatever we have performed on this application, it just recorded. As I said, Selenium IDE, it's a kind of a handicam. It has been recorded all the steps that we have performed on the application. Okay. Now we'll try to replay. Now see here, I'm just replaying this test case. If I say replay, just observe in the background, it is opening eb.com. Once it opens eb.com, it is going to enter the camera and it is going to click on search button. It seems it clicked on search button. Now it is going to click on daily deals. See here. Now we are in the daily deals page. Now if you closely observe this particular test case, this test case, the background of this test case has been highlighted with a light green color. And if you observe this, there is a green color bar. It means this test case is being executed successfully without any issue. Okay. Now what we have done, we have recorded a script. First we have recorded a script and we replayed that script. Okay. Now we can export this script into different languages. We can export into Java, we can export into C sharp. And moreover, by default, whatever the script that you are able to see here, this script, this is basically HTML script. This script is in the form of HTML. This HTML based script can be converted into Java, C sharp. Now, if you want to convert, the third option that I'm explaining, go to file menu, there is something called export test case as, and here you can export into any flavor that you want. C Here as of now it is showing Ruby. Again in Ruby there are some set of flavors we have. So do you want to export Ruby the Webdriver, Ruby remote control, like older version? Okay, Python, Java, C Sharp. So here in general, we in our class we are basically going to use Java Gen for Webdriver because most of the organizations expect this. Here I'm exporting the one of the here Java Gen for Webdriver flavor. Okay, here I'm going to save in under this particular folder. Let me say eBay demo. I'm saying eBay demo, and I'm going to save under this particular folder. So I'm giving the name as eBay demo here. Okay. So now what we have done, we have exported this script into different languages. We have used this option. We have exported into Java here. Okay. Now here, let us go to the folder where we have exported this particular script. Here you can see this eBay demo. And you can see the file type as Java file there. Okay. Now there is something called this is called as Eclipse editor. Give a minute. Here this is Eclipse editor. Again, don't worry about this. This as of now maybe this seems to be like a monster, but it's not really. Once you start digging into things, it's very easy. This is Eclipse. This is basically a Java editor. Here, this is the place where we write our Selenium programs. Okay. Even I will let you know. I will guide how to install the Selenium, this Eclipse also. However, as of now, see here. First, let me go to the file here. I'm just copying this particular file. I'm copying this particular Java file here. Come on. Okay. Now I'm just pasting here. I have copied a Java file and I'm pasting over here. And as of now, as I said, don't concern about the technical part. Just try to understand the execution, overall execution here. Okay, yeah, I just need to comment this line, and here it is a small e. Okay, that's it. Now see here, this is called a Selenium Webdriver using Java. Now again, when you look at this program, if you look at this program, this seems to be like a monster. Okay. This seems to be like a bigger logic, but to be frank, this is not that much tough. It is basically very easy. Once you once you complete around 40% of the course, around like once you complete the Java, you'll easily understand what are all these things. Okay, what is this? What are all these things? And you are going to understand what is this @ before, what is this @ test. You are going to understand all these things. Probably once after you complete the 40% of the course. Right away, don't dig into this, you'll get confused. Okay. Now see here, this is Selenium Webdriver. Now I'm trying to execute this script. As of now, concentrate how the script is being executed. So now we have exported this script into Selenium Webdriver format, and moreover, it's been exported into Java flavor. Now we are executing the script here. Now the same script, here I was explaining we can prepare one script and we can make it, we can execute on 120 plus combinations, right? This is one of the combination. Now once this executes, we will try to execute the same script on Google Chrome. Now basically now this script is going to work on Firefox. It is going to execute the script on Firefox browser. Once this is done, I'm saying we'll try to understand how to execute the same script on Google Chrome. It's a bit slow in a day for the first time. Basically, it will take a bit time to open. See here, every auxiliary has opened the Firefox browser, and now if you close the auxiliary here, this right side bottom corner, there is Webdriver. It means this is a browser which has been opened by the Selenium Webdriver. Now see here, it is waiting for this browser to stabilize. Basically, Selenium will wait by default to wait this browser to stabilize. Now once this browser stabilizes, it is going to enter camera and it is going to click on search. It means it is going to execute the same steps that we have done. Here it has entered camera and it is clicked on search. And then here it is going to click on daily deals. And once it clicked on daily deals, it is going to close the browser. It's so fast. Okay, if you really want to monitor, let me comment one line here, so which is not going to close the browser. Now I'll try to execute this. Now see here, again it is going to execute. Now in this case, it is not going to close the browser. See here, it's opening the Firefox. Now in this case, it is not going to close the browser. Now it is going to enter camera here. But it is waiting for the browser to stabilize. The left top corner, that's still waiting. Let's try it for a while. It seems it's a bit slow. Yeah, application is a bit slow, so now the Selenium is waiting for this browser to stabilize. Okay, let it execute. Here, meanwhile, we'll try to execute this script in Google Chrome. Okay, I need to do a little bit modification over here. Let me copy that statement here. I'm just copying a statement here for executing on Google Chrome. Okay. Now if I execute this script, it is going to execute and here it seems, can you all agree? This Webdriver, it seems it has been executed successfully. Okay, it is in the daily deal screen and here you can agree have Webdriver. Now in this case, it did not close. I'm just closing this. Now I'll try to execute the same script in Google Chrome. I have done a little bit modification here. Okay. Now we'll try to execute the same script on Google Chrome here. Okay. As of now, don't bother what actually I have done technically. We'll discuss those things. Now we'll try to understand how it is going to execute in Google Chrome now. So now it is opening Google Chrome. And the same script is going to be executed the same flow. Like it is trying to open eBay.com here. And then it will try to enter camera, and then it will click on search button. What happened? No, oh, it didn't do not respond anymore. We'll see. similar way, we can execute the same script on Internet Explorer also. Yeah, let's write this to execute in Google Chrome. Now see here, it is opening ab.com. In Google Chrome, it is opening ab.com. And again, it is here also, it is waiting for this browser to stabilize. Okay, once this stabilizes, it's going to enter Tamara here. It is going to click on the search. Let's wait till this execution completes. Come on. So that this tool is kind of loading. It will wait for a while. Let's see here, it has entered Tamara. I click on search. Again, now it is getting wait over here in the left top corner. Okay, now once again the browser stabilizes, it's going to click on daily deals here. Okay. Yeah, click on daily deals. So the same script we can make it to execute on Internet Explorer. The same script we can make it to execute on a different machine. With say this is a Windows operating system, right? So I want to execute the same script on Linux, say Firefox 25th version. I can configure this script to execute on a Linux machine with Firefox 25th version. That kind of capability is there with the Selenium out there. Okay, this is all about Selenium, and this is just an introduction class. It's here we understood advantage of Selenium, and we compared with QTP, and we analyzed each and every point with a technical reason. And this is a sample script where we executed the script in Firefox and Google Chrome. Yeah. Thanks everyone.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.